All right, welcome back, everybody, to our same lab that we're going to keep increasing on. All right, so right now we have our VLANs, right? We go in here into our layer 3 switch. And we do a show VLAN brief. And we see that we have VLAN 10, and we have that particular computer assigned to this port. How do we know that? I mean, if you just do simple, this is a small lab, so you can get away with doing this. You'll start. You can see that interface VLAN 10, there is an IP address. We put one, and as well under interface 1 is assigned to this particular VLAN. Now, one of the things that we did previously in this particular router, we did some housekeeping commands. Now, we're not going to do the same housekeeping commands, but we are going to enable something called an IP default gateway on this particular switch, and we need to turn on telnet. We'll just do very simple telnet, and let me tell you why. If you're within the same segment of the switch, you're able to telnet in. If you're not, you won't be able to telnet in if you don't have the default gateway. But let's prove that theory. That's what Cisco states. So let's prove that theory. So we're going to enable just telnet on the switch. You just do line VTY 015, password Cisco, and then login. That's the error you get because you got to first put a password and then do login. Now, I didn't do a username or password or anything like that. Okay. All I did, I just enabled the telnet lines. If you look at it, show start all the way to the bottom. All I did was enable the telnet lines with a password of Cisco, a plain text password. This is just to prove a point. So if I'm in this segment, I should be, it has an IP address, which is 10.253. I should be able to go ahead and telnet in. I'm going to do telnet 192.168.10.253. Enter, password, Cisco. I'm in, right? Now we don't have any passwords there, so, but still, I'm in, right? Cool. And we're going to exit. And I can still pay, obviously pay my gateway, 192.168.10.254. And I can ping all the way across to 30.254. I believe it's the last LAN. Not 30.254, but 30.1, which is the PC. 30.1. We should be able to ping to that. Let's go. Now we got a reply there. Let's do it again. There we go. I just don't have the time for the packet tracer. Good thing for the fast forward button. Now, we saw we were able to tell it into the switch. Let's do it from a different network. We have connectivity all the way across. So let's see if Cisco's statement or the author of Cisco's statement or that Cisco statement is true. So we're going to say not telnet 192.168.10.253. It says trying. And it's going to kick me out if it hasn't done it by now. So it's not responding. Can I ping it? 192.168.10.253. Any day now. I don't have time to be playing games. So I can't ping it. Can I ping 10.1? So are we having a connectivity issue? No, I can ping 10.1. So I can't ping the switch, and I can't get into the switch. All right, so let's do this. Let's go into the switch, and let's see if that holds true with the IP default gateway. We've configured telnet, right? Just a plain password, no username or anything, plain text password. And now we're going to do this. Config T, IP, because we have an IP address already on the VLAN, IP default, IP default hyphen, okay. I'm just going to copy paste. There we go. Incomplete command. Oh, and the IP address. Okay, it's a layer 3 switch. 192.168.10. Oh, no, that's true. That is true. You need to do that. Sorry, my bad. All right, there you go. So now we have an IP default gateway set there. Awesome. All right, so we know we're able to do it from this one place. I forgot that, we had to put the IP address. Sorry. Brain fart there. So let's tell it again to 10.253. Okay, so we can ping now. I said toner, but I typed pain. Awesome. As you know where my brain's at. 192.168.10.253. Now we can telnet in Cisco, and now we're in. So it does hold true. It does hold true. You are able to ping through the switch. You can get to your destination, anybody down here, but you don't have access, even if it has an IP address, and I didn't put any security on there, but you don't have access to get to the switch or ping the switch, apparently. All right, but you're definitely not going to be able to telnet in unless you have that IP default gateway. You can't do that. Let's go ahead and do it with this one. Because we got to test everybody, right? Telnet 192.168.10.253. Cisco. And you're in. So now you know. And this used to be a question way back in the day for the CCNA. Right, that you would literally have to, you know, when you're configuring housekeeping commands, are you going to, when you're doing, especially in the switch, you need to put that IP default gateway. Because even if you're in a different VLAN in right here in the same switch, and you're trying to get into that VLAN, you're not going to be able to do that through, you know, that 10. If you're, let's say the 10 and the 20 would be underneath here, the 10 and the 20 are underneath here. You will not be able to tell that into the 10, and you will not be, or the 10 to be able to tell it to the 20 in the same switch, because you're in a different broadcast domain. You still need to put the IP default gateways for each one. Remember, these are sub interfaces that we have. Yeah, I'm going to bypass that. Sorry. Don't want to type in any more passwords. Okay. Not going to do it. I'll do show IP in brief. All right, so these are sub-interfaces. Each sub-interface is its own network, so different broadcast domains. So you would need to put the default gateway for each network in the switch if you want to gain access through Telnet, because it will still consider it a foreign network because you're in a different broadcast domain. So now you know. The whole point of this lab is, okay, we enabled a basic Telnet. We did the first 16 lines. Okay, we did Telnet. Password Cisco. That's it. No username or password. No security. Just a little plain text password. Within the same VLAN, within the same segment, within the same broadcast domain, I can telnet in without an issue. When you go to another network, the 20.0, you can't ping it. You can't telnet it at all. The switch. You can go through it, but you can't get in it. Not until you do the IP, that's a global command, the IP space default hyphen gateway and the IP address of the gateway. Now the switch knows who the gateway is, and when you're coming through, boom, you're able to get into it and you're able to ping it as well. So if you want to do this for management purposes, obviously you don't want to do this in real world, getting to somebody else's VLAN, unless that's what you want. But for management purposes, let's say you leave the default VLAN, you know, VLAN 1, and you put an IP address on there, make sure you put an IP address on the native VLAN. You need to put the gateway for the native VLAN, which would be, let's say, 1.254. And the IP of the switch would be 1.253, because it's VLAN 1. And then you'll be able to get from wherever you're at inside those switches, and then you'll be able to manage it. Okay? So that was the whole point of this lab, knowing that when you configure, again, Telnet, you do an IP default gateway command with the IP address, so anybody else can get in. Obviously, I'm just showing you that that's the way it needs to be, but security laws. But what about security? Obviously, we need to secure it, all right, because we don't want anybody being able to tell it into different VLANs, okay? All right, I'll see everybody in the next one. Pretty easy.